Good morning, students. In the last class regarding chemistry, we have started our chapter matter. Now, in this, I have told you already in physics we have studied regarding matter, like how the arrangement of molecules in solids, liquids, and gases. Similarly, as we have studied in the physics, the same thing is there in chemistry. Hence, I am not dealing with that. Already we have studied. Next, today we will start our chapter on the same. In the same chapter, we have law of conservation of mass. What we are reading? Law of conservation of mass. There are activities based on this. If you want, you take out your textbook, page number 17. Okay. Now, in this, conservation of mass means, let us do the activity first, then you can understand what do you mean by conservation of mass. In this, first, in order to prove the conservation of mass, you require the materials like a conical flask. Like this, there will be a flask in the laboratory. A conical flask we call. Now, on the top of the flask, we will be fitting it with a cork. Okay? Now, to this cork, there will be a small hole. Inside this flask, you will be taking a small tube, like a small test tube, we call ignition tube. Ignition tube we call. Now, this tube is connected by using a thread. Now, in this, what we are doing, first take sodium symbol. I am writing in the, as it is with chemistry, I am writing in the symbols, sodium sulfate. Okay, sodium sulfate solution I am taking, and in the ignition tube, barium chloride, BaCl2. These are the two substances in the form of a solution I am taking. Now, place, take 100 ml of sodium sulfate and 100 ml of BaCl2 solution in ignition tube and a conical flask. Now, tie this ignition tube with a thread and the other end you take it out of the cork. Now, place this in the whole thing in a balance. So, in the laboratory there will be a balance. Okay? Physical balance we call. Place this in the balance and find out the weight of the container along with all these contents like barium chloride, sodium sulfate and a thread, the cork. Weight of all these things you find out. Okay? After weighing all these things, let us assume the weight you got it as 100 grams. Okay? Placing all these things in a physical balance and find out the weight of all the cork, thread, conical flask, ignition tube, barium chloride and sodium sulfate. Let the weight of these things be 100 grams. Now, slowly tilt. What you need to tilt? Your ignition tube. Slowly tilt your ignition tube. Here, one important precaution is you must close the mouth of the conical flask tightly with the cork. Okay? Now, slowly tilt the ignition tube. Then what happens? The ignition, whatever solution is there in BaCl2, it will be, Whenever you are tilting, the solution will be coming from the ignition tube and mixing it with sodium sulfate. Yes or no? Whenever you are tilting the ignition tube, the solution barium chloride is coming out of the ignition tube and falling into the sodium sulfate. Now, what after the barium chloride falls and there undergoes a reaction, Na2SO4 plus BaCl2. Are they both chemicals? Yes. They both will be combining and undergoing a reaction like Na2. Here reaction is not required. Even then I am telling you NaCl plus BaSO4. Reaction undergoes between sodium sulfate and barium chloride. Now, whatever reaction, chemical reaction is occurring. Now the same thing, again you place it in the physical balance. Now again, find out the weight after the chemical reaction. As we have tilted now, our ignition tube we have tilted and that barium chloride is mixing with sodium sulfate. Now, if you find out the weight of the whole thing after the chemical reaction has undergone, you will say that the weight is again 100 grams. Initially, how much it is? 100 grams. Now, how much it is? 100 grams. See, before the reaction, initially we have taken a conical flask, some solutions in the ignition tube and the conical flask, a thread and a cork. There we didn't see any chemical reaction, just we have placed and find out the weight before the reaction has occurred. Its weight was 100 grams. After I have tilted, both are mixing and there undergoes a chemical reaction. Again the weight I have found it as 100 grams. From this, what can I say? The weight of the content before the reaction is equal to the weight of the contents after the reaction has occurred. Okay? This gives conservation of mass. Conservation means before, initially how much it was there. After the reaction has undergone also, you are getting the same mass. Okay? This is law of conservation of mass. In the exam, they may ask you, write an activity to prove law of conservation of mass. Okay? Then you must write this activity. Okay, children? First, you write aim, materials, procedure and the observation. Okay? Now here mass is conserved. After this you have another topic called combustion. What do you mean by combustion? Combustion means, look at here, C-O-M-B-U-S-T-I-O-N. Burning of any substance in the presence of oxygen is called combustion. Oxygen symbol you already know, O2. Any substance. See, you all might be familiar. Take a candle and a matchstick. Light the matchstick. You will be putting it to the wick of the candle. Then what happens to your candle? It starts lighting. Okay? That is combustion. When you are lighting the candle, is there a presence of oxygen there in the atmosphere? Yes. Combustion means burning of any substance in the presence of oxygen is called combustion. Okay, children? Yeah, today I have told you only one activity and the definition of combustion. Your homework for today is write an activity to prove law of conservation of mass. Okay, second one is define combustion. Okay children, these are the homework questions. Try to write the activity in your own words. Don't copy from the textbook. Okay children, thank you.